Good morning. In the kingdom of fools. My question was, this kingdom of fools, where the king and ministers are idiots, the people are no less. They are equally idiots. The proof is, if the authority asked people to do something insensible, people did that. People did that because why did people follow what king and ministers asked them to do? Why people did that without any protest? Can you tell me? First reason is, of course, they were afraid of being punished, right? The first reason they followed the authority without question was the fear of death. First reason was fear of death. Fear of punishment, you can say whatever. Punishment could be in any form. What was the other reason they did not speak up? What was the other reason the people did not speak up? You can raise hand, those who are online or offline. Anyone can raise hand. I'll ask. Yes, what's the reason they did not speak up? Raise hand. Only then I'll come to know. Yes. Gurupal? Huh? I'm saying Gurupal. Are you Gurupal? Say, yes, ma'am, Gurupal. I'm Gurupal. Yes, now speak the answer. I think they were also. That we have already discussed. If they followed the authorities' foolish orders, they were equally foolish. But now we are assessing, we are analyzing the reason. Like why they acted foolishly. One reason is fear of punishment. Anshya, what's the other reason? Can you repeat, please? Repeat. Okay. So Anshya says that they thought like what king or the ministers are doing for them, that is good. So they did it. It's not written in the story. It's not the reason also. That reason is given. We read it out yesterday. What's that reason for which they followed the rule unquestioningly? Yes. The reason we read out yesterday. Okay, let me give you a clue, a hint. The guru decided that he would not stay in the same kingdom. But disciple decided to stay there. Why did the disciple decide to stay there? Yes. Yes, because everything was cheap. They could get everything at rupee one. Whatsoever expensive thing they wanted, they could get it only for rupee one. So they did not mind. People followed the king's orders unquestioningly because they did not mind because the things were all equivalent to being free. So people don't mind anything when you give them the things free of cost. Got it? This is the common mentality of human beings. But what kind of human beings? Those who are a little selfish. Those who don't mind the welfare of the country, they like the things to be given to them free of cost. So that's why these people did not mind insensible decision of the government, despite the fact the orders were being foolish. Because they knew like what will happen if they would work at night instead of working in the morning, so what? Because in the end, they would be getting everything so cheap. That made them support foolish government. Is that clear? Only one person protested, only one person disliked, that is Guru. That Guru is supposed to be the, he is symbolic of what kind of character, Guru? He is symbolic of a wise citizen. He is a wise citizen who knows that if the authorities are giving him something free of cost, then when there will be emergency, then that king will not spare them. Then what will that king do in case of emergency? You cannot imagine. If our government gives us everything free of cost, and tomorrow if China attacks us, from where will we get all the defense mechanism? From where will we get the money to fight against the enemies? If today our country, we get everything free of cost, and if there is the way there was, there has been a pandemic, the pandemic is still going on. Can we imagine how much the government has already spent upon healthcare? Can we imagine? Can we imagine? We cannot. Because when there is one person who doesn't get the facility, that very minute, what happens? The people are there to question the government, like what you did. The government keeps on doing. But what happens? But what happens? The moment there is some little shortage of something, the government is questioned, and government has to be questioned. We don't have to ask God to give us the healthcare system. The government's job is to do these things. The government's job is to give us good infrastructure, like good roads, 24-hour electricity supply, 24-hour water supply. It is government's job. They have to provide all the health facilities. Right? Government's job is this. But government cannot do these things when the government is not collecting its revenue. From where does the government's income come? Come on, tell me. From what it gets from us through tax. If something is to be, if we are to purchase a packet of biscuit which might cost rupees 5, but if we give 6 rupees for it, 1 rupee might go into the pocket of government. So what? What's the problem? 5 rupees are going into the pocket of the person who is making the biscuit. It's okay. He also deserves. If I am producing a packet of biscuit, don't I need 5 rupees back? I have to pay to my laborers. I have to pay for machinery. I have to get the money for my hard work also. I deserve to get 5 on 5. But what about government, the one who is doing everything for us? For me also, for you also. If 1 rupee is going in the pocket of government, so what? Why to crib? But if some government says that we'll give you 1 rupee for a packet of biscuit, something which should cost that person 6 rupees, something which should cost us 6 rupees, and if we give 1 rupee, what will happen? Can you imagine? The government is getting no revenue, number one. Number two, the person, if I was the producer, I won't get any money. How will I give money to my laborers? How will I get money for my machinery? What about my hard work? If I am not getting any money, then I will stop. I'll stop the factory. For 5 months or 6 months, you may keep on getting the biscuits because that was the previous stock. But what about after 6 months? फिर कहां से बिस्किट आएंगे? Finish. तब तक government's money will also finish. From where will the government run the business? So this is the system. If we go by train, if we are spending 300 rupees on a ticket, and out of 300, if 250 is going in the pocket of railways, and 50 rupees to the pocket of government. So what? Who is going to build these trains? Trains kahan se aa rahi hain? Are we giving money for making of the trains? One train costs, can you imagine the cost of one bogie? Can you imagine? It is worth in billions. Who gives money for the purchase of one train? Come on, tell. The moment we have to go to somebody, some place, we just think about booking a ticket. Do we ever think about purchasing a train? Or do we think about, making a train? Ye sab kaam piche se chal rahe hain. Because we are giving extra 50 rupees or extra 100 rupees or extra something which is going somewhere, and from there the administration is working. China last year was so active. 24 hours and 12 months our army is standing at the borders. Is it only the army which is getting the salary or something else? So much of machinery is being deployed at the borders. Do you know the cost of one tank? Can we imagine the cost of one tank? How many tanks are already there at the borders? Can we imagine? We cannot. How is the system running? Through the revenue the government is collecting, the revenue which is going from our pocket to the pocket of government. Then why to crib? If we have to pay some tax, why to crib? Okay, road toll plazas we have destroyed. You know, we people, we don't want, like, we are not happy with government's some decision. And what we have done, we have stopped all the road toll plazas. If the government was making so many beautiful roads, if we have to go to some place, we want beautiful roads. The place where some, what we call them? Speed breaker? No, speed breakers are for our safety. Like those bumps, those pits. If the broken roads come, we start blaming authorities. Kya kaam kar rahe hain wo log? Who the authorities are? Somebody like us? Will they bring money from their own home and build the road? Road ko jo toll plaza sabne sare band karwa diye. Ab roads tooti hai to theek kaun karega? Kahan se money aayega? That we will not think. Theek hai, democracy hai, we can do anything here. Okay, here if we have some grudges with the government, doesn't mean that we stop the progress of our country. अपनी कंट्री को तो नहीं रोको ना आप. लेट योर कंट्री मूव ऑन एज इट्स ओन पेस. इफ यू हैव अ प्रॉब्लम विद मी, यू कैन हैव सो मेनी वेज आउट टू सॉर्ट आउट योर ग्रजेस, बट डजंट मीन दैट यू स्टॉप, दैट यू स्टार्ट पेल्टिंग स्टोन्स एट मी एंड देन यू विल बी थ्रोइंग द स्टोन्स एट मी. तो ये भी टूट जाए, ब्लैक बोर्ड भी टूट जाए, डेस्क भी टूट जाए, पैंस बेचारे भी जाए, cubes bhi jaye, then what will happen? Will I lose something or will you people lose something? Ye batao. Main to fir bhi bhag jaungi yahan se. The loss which this class will occur, that loss will be irreparable. Or in the end, the fee hike will be there. Zyada fee do, sari class ko dobara repair kar denge. In the end, who will be giving it? You. So fair, this is what we are doing for the country. And then we crib. Why inflation? How many Jio towers were destroyed in Punjab? We can't count more than 1700. What the towers have to do? Phone connection we want 24 hours. We want network. Abhi hamare paas network nahi hai, so what will these children do there? Network we want 24 hours, 12 months. Then why do we disrupt the system? This we need to understand. our fight is with the authorities. Our fight is not with our country. Our fight is never with the developmental projects of our country. Okay, let us not have personal grudges with the system. If we are so justice prone, then we would know like what kind of fight it should be. The fight should be justified. Okay, this chapter is very much, you know, a replica of the kind of system which prevails. This chapter in the Kingdom of Fools is actually, you know, the copy of a poem, A Tale of Melon City. Read that poem, all of you. A Tale of Melon City. That is a poem. It's even prescribed in 11th standard book also. So read that poem, A Tale of Melon City. This chapter, this story is exactly the replica of that. And this chapter is actually a satire on authorities. It's a satire on authorities or even common people. Even common people. What's a satire? Satire is a comment on the foibles or weaknesses or something wrong. When supposing you do something wrong, you start doing, imagine anyone. Then I want to criticize some system, but I don't say it directly. I say it humorously. Supposing you've got very bad marks, you've got 0 out of 10. Then if I say, you've got very bad marks, why have you got 0? Then maybe you will not have any effect of it. Because the one who got 0 will not mind teacher saying anything. Getting the one who got 0 will not mind anything. But if I say, beta, you did very well. It was a magnificent job. Clap for him. What will happen? Then he might feel ashamed of himself. The moment the whole class will clap for his poor achievement, then it might affect him. So this is a humorous way of correcting him. The purpose was to correct him. But how did I correct him? In a humorous way. And in literary sense, we call it satire. Okay, and in layman term, many of you call it taunt. Sarcasm. Sarcasm is also what? Literary term. It's a sarcasm, and that sarcasm is used in satire. Okay, we'll be talking about what satire is in details later on. Now let's finish off the chapter. Okay, we were on page number. What was the page number? 19. So, but the disciple wouldn't listen to the guru's wisdom. He wanted to stay. The guru finally gave up and said, "Do what you want. I am going," and left. The disciple stayed on, ate his fill every day, bananas and ghee and rice and wheat, and grew fat like a street side sacred bull. So it's a satire. Like if you will be idle and if you're getting everything free of cost, then you will become a useless person. If you're given everything free of cost, what will happen? You'll become a useless person. The meaning is because you will not mind working hard. If the governments will give you free of cost everything, people will stop working hard. Okay? When I gave you one example of biscuits, packet of biscuit, number one, everybody will get free packet of biscuit, 1 rupee. Number one, consumption will increase. Number two, production will stop. Imagine the condition then. Those who are the consumers, they'll keep on eating up and eating up. And those who are the providers, they will start starving. Okay. So one bright day, A thief broke into a rich merchant's house. This story we had read out. No, yesterday we read out this part. Like a thief came into the merchant's house. After having done the thievery or the stealing, that thief was going to jump or climb up the wall. So when he was jumping through the wall being old collapsed and the thief died because of the collapsing of the wall. The thief died. The thief had come for stealing and he died. Story could have finished. But the brother of the thief, this is what is happening in our country also. The people, those who are coming to limelight are the ones, those who are themselves criminals. Okay, they want to come to power by hook or by crook. If one person is sitting on chair, then 20% are becoming together. Maybe they were hardcore enemies. Yes. Yes. If I elect, if from your class we elect one child on the basis of that child's merit, good academic record, good behavior, good activities record, everything fine. If we elect him or her, we make him the overall monitor of the class. Then 20, you know, bullies of the class, 20 children who are villainous, who are otherwise enemies of each other. But they want, like, how could he become the monitor? Then they all 20 will become together. And they will plot against that one person who has been made the monitor. And then the rest of the 30 children, will they vote for that, those 20 together or one person? Come on, tell me. Will you vote for 20, those who got together? Those bunch of crooks? Ki wo one jo honest yahan baitha hai. Batao. You will of course go for the one who is honest. Whosoever. Because that one came because of his or her merit. Aur sabse badi baat hai, wo one came because of you people's vote. When he was made the monitor, then the class was asked. That's why he was selected. A baki 20 kuch bhi karein. That doesn't make any difference. So try to understand this democratic system of the country. If one person has got an authority, to wo apne aap aake nahi baitha. We people made him the, we gave him the chair, number one. Number two, analyze the situation. Which people are against him? The ones who are against him, what kind of people are they? If they had that much of caliber, why didn't they become the chairperson earlier? So become analytic. Don't follow the crowds. Don't follow me. Don't follow anyone. Apply your mind. Have good sense to see like what is right and what is going on. First comes country, nothing else. No person comes first. First comes our country. That's it. Or when we talk about our country, then all differences you will see will merge. They will all disappear. When because of our one act, our country is going to be defamed at international level. Should we do that? Our country comes first. Country ka naam kharab karna is ours mistake. Apni country ke saath don't play. Be for your country. Be with your country. Uske aage kuch nahi. Nothing personal. Nothing my 1 rupee profit or nothing about my 6 rupees profit. Country comes first. Okay, when we all will understand this, then no one can do anything against us. So, okay, so the thief, you know, he died on the spot and his brother went to the court and filed a case that his brother should be given the justice. The justice was already done. The thief died. The one who had done the wrong thing died. God gave him punishment. Justice was already done. Now, what kind of justice he wanted? Now, his brother wanted injustice. And this is what the media is exposing. The wrongdoers are pleading. The wrongdoers are pleading the guilty case. They say, like, we are right and give punishment to the right one. This is what is happening in our country also. So that person, brother, asked the justice for his brother. And the king said, okay, we will give justice. So they called the merchant. Should the merchant be, should he be called to court? He was just sitting at his own home. If he is rich, if he has got everything at his home, is it his mistake? Why should he be penalized? Come on. The one who has earned money, the one who has become rich, is it his mistake? And he is being penalized. Ki aa jao beta court mein. And he came. He had to, because system is asking him to come to court. Right? So he comes to the court and he puts forward his case. What his case is that, sir, what I have done? It was a thief who came to my house. And when he was running off, he died. But you must be punished because it was your wall. Okay, sir, if it was my wall, then give punishment to the one who made the wall. Who made the wall? 100 years ago, a mason, the one who made the wall. I know him. So the person who made wall about 100 years ago, he is called. Has he anything to do with the justice for the thief? But this is happening. So the one who does something right, who did something for his own self or for the merchant or for the house, he is called. Okay, he says, okay, sir, if you are to blame somebody, then you call that woman or the dancer who was passing by the side and she distracted me. The king said, okay, let's call that girl who was the cause of your distraction, right? So let's read from here. So who is going to be called now? Who is going to be called? Anji, who is going to be called now? The dancing girl, right? And why is the dancing girl going to be called? You tell. Come on. Why is the dancing girl going to be called? In the online classes also, Gurpal's hands are always up. And in the offline class also. Yeah, this girl, what's your name? Gurli, yes. The children whose hand, even this boy is very active today. What's your name? Huh? Raghav. In the online classes, he was not very active. But here he is. So this is what is required. So if you've come here, then be very active. Okay, give response. Anshya was always there with her answers. Gurpal was also there. Gurshan was also very active. Though I have never seen these children. But because of their hands, I know them. You know, there are some more. The moment I'll be listening their names, I'll come to know. Jaise jaise naam samne aayenge. You know? Anji, beta, yes. What were you saying? Why was the girl called? Yes, very nice. Because she distracted the bricklayer. Now the question is, did the dancer distract the bricklayer intentionally? No. She might have been passing by. Then why, where does the point come that she distracted the person? But even then, this girl is going to be called. If such foolish kings we will have, then this will happen. Okay, then we are to understand, do we have a foolish king or not? Do we have an insensible person? Okay, what is an insensible person? The one who doesn't work for the progress of the country. For 1 year, you people were at home. Did you people miss your classes even for one single day because of the school's mismanagement? Come on, yes or no? from day one your school started. Each exam was conducted, each competition was conducted, each activity was organized. Everything was done while the whole school, including teachers, were at home. Everything was done. What we call it? Management. Right? So, what point is that we will discuss tomorrow?